Today I'm going to show you how to replace a fuel injector on a BMW N20 4-cylinder engine. When we're done, we'll have to calibrate the fuel injector using our iSCAN SF. I've already disconnected the negative battery terminal and removed the cal cover. Now that I have all the engine covers off, I can go ahead and start removing the coils so that when we release the fuel from the lines, they don't damage the coils. Then we'll go ahead and remove the last two coils. And now I'll pull the acoustic cover off of the high pressure pump so we can access the fuel lines. And next I'm going to pull off the harness for the eccentric shaft motor by squeezing these two tabs and pulling straight up on it. And then after that, pop the O2 sensor connectors off just so we can get a little more room for the line that we're going to take off. Next, take this bracket off so we can access the line. Those are two E6s, and then there's a third one on the back of this bracket that I've already removed. And now I'm going to remove the ground nuts for the coils so we can get access to the brackets for the injector and get those lines out of the way when we release the injector lines. And then on the back, we're gonna pop the injector connectors off, which is just this little tab, and you can use a pocket screwdriver to pop that out. Pretty easy. And get that out of the way so we can get access to the supply line. And then get the remaining two connectors out. Sometimes they're a little bit hard to get out if they're crusty from dirt or something like that. And just move all that out of the way. All right, and then we're going to release the supply line. So I'm gonna crack this up at the top, and then usually I get rags just in case there's some residual pressure, and relieve that. Let the fuel out, and that's a 17. Loosen that up. Sometimes it takes a little bit to bleed off all the pressure. And just leave that there for a little bit while we get some of the other lines loosened up. So we'll also crack the 17 loose at the high pressure pump. Usually once all of the pressure's bled off at the top, you can remove that without any fuel coming out. Today we're going to be replacing injector on cylinder 2. So in order to do that, we're going to crack the 14 mil loose on all the injectors, since the rail is connected to all of them and you have to rotate that whole thing back to get access to the injectors themselves. And once all those are loose, move those off. And then we can go ahead and start loosening the rail itself so that we can rotate it back. And those are going to be E8s. Loosen that up enough, move this bracket out of the way, make sure they're all loose. Sometimes they get stuck on the threads, and then we can go ahead and move that out of the way. Next, we're going to go ahead and remove the bracket. That's the hold down bracket for the injectors, which is 2 10 mils. Just back those out. It releases the tension on the injectors. And go ahead and pull that off. And then you can see the injector there. This is the injector we're going to be replacing, cylinder 2. And definitely pay attention to which way the connectors face, so that when you put it all back together, you don't have it facing the wrong way. That can happen. This is a puller that I like using. There are a couple other available, and obviously there's a BMW specific one. I like using this because it's a little more compact and just easier to use. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this, which just screws onto the threads of the injector. And then you can slide it out, just like that. Here's the injector, a little bit of rust corrosion on the tip, but not too bad. And that's how we do it. Here's our new injector. It comes with a new Teflon seal. It does not come with a new decoupling element, so we will need to replace that when we're replacing the injector. And you can see the seam right there. That seam faces up, so we'll put that on there, and then the tabs just pop on. It will be loose, but it stays in place. Another thing to note, this is going to be our injector calibration number 215, and that's what we will need to put into the calibration service function in order to calibrate the injectors after the repair. Now we can go ahead and install it. Make sure that the connector is facing the correct way. And then once we get it in there, you can use any number of tools to reinstall it. Make sure it's seated properly all the way in the head. And once it's seated, then we can put the bracket back on. And when we put the bracket on, sometimes you'll need to rotate the injector just a little bit so it fits the bracket. If it's off, the bracket won't go on right where that shape is right there. And then try to tighten these down evenly. And then once you get it seated, remember to torque it to factory specifications. And like I mentioned before, we'll torque this to factory specifications. Make sure it's seated properly and the injectors are installed correctly. Now that I've got the fuel lines tight, I'm going to continue reassembling in the reverse order of removal. When done, I'll enter that 3-digit code we saw earlier on the injector into the DME using my iSCAN SF. Now with the engine reassembled, it's time to perform the injection quantity compensation. Begin by selecting the vehicle you're working on. In this video, we are using a 2013 BMW 328i. Begin by tapping Euro. Tap BMW, tap Diagnostic, tap Auto Detect Models, confirm by pressing Enter. And we're confirming that this is the right car, and that looks correct, so tap Enter. Tap Service Function, tap Drive, tap Injector Rate Adjustment. Tap Enter, and we're working on an N20, so confirm by pressing Enter. Tap Enter, and since we replaced injector number 2, we're going to hit cylinder 2 and press Enter. We'll be entering a new calibration value, so select that, select cylinder 2, and our calibration number was 215. So we enter that in, tap OK, and tap Enter to save that value. turn off accessories. Wait 10 seconds. Turn accessory back on. Confirm by tapping enter. And the value was saved. Tap enter. The value might be a little bit different due to the DME, but everything looks good. So we're finished here and we can hit enter to continue. Tap end, and then we can go ahead and exit out. Be sure to clear any fault codes related to the injector, run the engine, and double check for fuel leaks or any other issues. Thanks for hanging out. I'll see you next time.